Question 1. What do you think Holbein was trying to achieve with the anamorphic feature of the portrait? This painting is more about what you cannot see than what you can. Holbein painted the concept that representation does not equal reality. Nothing is ever as it seems. This painting showcases all of the different things we as humans have accomplished up until that point, which is why the anamorphic skull is so important in this painting. Those kind of achievements don't last forever. There's a beginning and an end to our time on this earth, and what we can contribute in that time will enrich the lives of those who come after us, but it doesn't keep us immortal. I liked all of the hidden meanings that lived in this painting, and I wanted to take Rauschenberg's approach to recreating the ambassadors with the collage method that he depicts in his artwork, but with relevant brand and pop culture references to understand and bring to life what Holbein was trying to do. In Holbein's portrait, the men are the main focal point, but what is truly important is what lies between them. In my Rauschenberg-inspired rendition of The Ambassadors, I place some of our incredible achievements that will take us into the future on the top half. In how Holbein painted the bottom half of the shelf to represent Europe in discord, I did the same with pulling elements which represent some form of discord in our society. These news outlets are not necessarily the cause of any discord, but certainly play the medium in bringing the messages of discord to the people. The TV that outlines the entire picture represents the same thing that the skull in The Ambassadors does. Mass media and broadcast, similar to the skull which symbolizes death, are always around us.
Question 2. Question 2. Do the artists create an experience of changing anamorphic art in some way? These talented artists were creative and clever in their paintings. By utilizing certain angles to distort the image, your interpretation of the painting changes as well. Like in Holbein's art, we see all items that symbolize the 1500s era. What we don't see is the skull. Once the viewer spots the distortion, their interpretation of the painting is changed. This applies to Gonzalez Day's photo, Erased Lynchings. The photo appears as a bunch of men in suits standing around at night. If it wasn't for the title of the photo, Erased Lynchings, we wouldn't know the meaning or the purpose behind the photo. In Rauschenberg's photo, we see many images in one. From a distance, the photo seems like many colors without any meaning, but up close, we see separate images that create a story. Greasebox photo demonstrates a great example of distortion. The man in the image is seen many times in what appears to be a funhouse type of mirror. Holzer's image creates a very obvious message that is reflected in the river. If you look closely, you'll spot this image was taken in Providence, Rhode Island, a city that looks very beautiful and has stunning landmarks, but has a rich history of mafia groups. This represents anamorphic art because the city isn't always what it seems.
The Mona Lisa, painted in 1503 by Leonardo da Vinci, is the perfect example of how art from the 1500s lives in today's culture. Art equals culture, so the Mona Lisa has gone through many culture shocks to stay relevant with the times.